Hello students, in this video we are going to see the details of 8237 DMA controller. So DMA stands for direct memory access. Usually data is transferred between memory and external devices through the accumulator. When bulk data transfer is to be made, routing each data byte through the accumulator is a time consuming operation. In such cases, data transfer can be made rapidly by direct memory access without involving the accumulator. Okay, so that is the function of DMA. So direct memory access technique is commonly used for high speed data transfer directly between the memory and peripheral devices without intervention of microprocessor. The DMA controller data transfer does not require software, hence it is a faster than microprocessor controlled data transfer. This technique is used in any system like floppy disk, hard disk drive system, then high speed analog to digital conversion, etc. The DMA controller is a processor capable only of copying data at a high speed from one location to another location. See that DMA controller operation. See the first diagram when DMA does not operate. Okay, that is actually the data transfer takes place through CPU. Okay, so this is CPU. This is DMA controller. This is memory. This is peripheral devices. So the data are transmitted between memory and peripheral devices through CPU only. Okay, see here, the address bus, data bus and control bus are connected to the CPU only. Whereas, the DMA controller is not connected with the switches. So, in first diagram, the data are transmitted between memory and peripheral devices through CPU. See the second diagram. So, here the same diagram, but see the switch position. The switch position, that is address bus, data bus and control bus, all buses are connected to DMA controller. So that means the DMA controller takes care of address bus, data bus and control bus. Through these buses, the data are transmitted between memory and peripheral devices. Okay, so the first one, when DMA does not operate, second one when DMA operates. Okay, DMA operation. So in DMA controller, using IO read or write signal or memory read or memory write signal, using these two signals the data are transmitted between memory and peripheral devices. Okay, so this is the difference between normal operation and DMA controller operation. So these are the features of 8237. It has four independent DMA channels. Enable and disable control of individual request. Then possibility of memory to memory transfer. Then address is incremented or decremented. Then number of DMA channels can be increased by cascading. Then it has many programmable controls. So these are all the main features of 8237 DMA controller. So this is the pin diagram of 8237. It is a 40 pin IC chip dual in line package. The pin number 1, that is IO read signal. So IO read means it is a bidirectional control signal. In slave mode, it is an input control signal for read the control register. In master mode, it is an output signal. Okay, that is IO read act as output control signal used by the 8237 to access data from the peripheral during DMA read transfer. Then pin number 2, IO write signal. So this is also bidirectional IO write control signal. It is input control signal for writing DMA controller during programming mode and output control signal during DMA write cycle. Then third signal, memory read. It is an output signal used to access data from the selected memory location during read operation. Then fourth pin, memory write signal. It is an output signal used to write data to the selected memory location during write operation. Then pin number 5, this pin should always be at logic high level. An internal pull-up resistor will establish a logic high when the pin is left floating. It is recommended, however, the pin 5 be connected to VCC. Then pin number 6, that is ready signal. When ready input is tried low, this signal can be used to extend the memory read and write pulse to transfer data between slow memory and I/O devices. Then pin number 7, HLDA, hold acknowledgement signal. It is an input signal. This is hold acknowledgement signal to be sent by the processor to inform the acceptance of hold request. Okay, then pin number 8, address strobe. So this is output signal. It is used to latch the high byte memory address during DMA mode into an external latch. Then AEN, address enable. This pin is used to disable other bus drivers during DMA transfer. So that is the function of address enable signal. Then pin number 10, that is HRQ. This is hold request signal. It is an output signal. It is used to request the control of the system. That is the use of HRQ. Then pin number 11, chip select signal. So this is active as low signal to select 8237 during programming mode. That is the function of CES, chip select signal. Then pin number 12, clock signal. The clock input signal is used to generate the timing signal for control operations. Then pin number 13, reset signal. When the reset signal goes high, the command status, request, temporary registers are cleared. It is also clear the mask register. So this is the function of reset signal. Then pin number 25, 24, 14 and 15. That is DAC 0 to DAC 3. Okay, that is DMA acknowledge output signal. Okay, 4 DMA output signal. That is a DAC 0 to DAC 3. That is pin number 14, 15, 24 and 25 called DMA acknowledge outputs. These are output signals from 8237 to the I/O devices to inform the acceptance of DMA request. These outputs are programmable either active high or active low signals. Then pin number 16 to 19. That is DREQ 0 to 3. DMA request input line. Okay, these signals used by I/O devices to request for DMA transfer. So these are the operations of pin number 16 to 19. Four signals, DREQ 0 to 4. Then pin number 20 act as ground signal. That is VSS is nothing but ground signal. Then pin number 21, 22, 23, 26, 27, 28, 29 and 30. Okay, that is DB0 to DB7, that is I/O data bus. It is a bidirectional data bus which is connected to the system bus which carries data. Okay, so totally 8 lines, DB0 to DB7. So these are all bidirectional data bus which is connected to the system bus which carries data. Then pin number 31, that is VCC, here plus 5 volt power supply is required for 8237. Then A0, that is pin number 32, 33, 34 and 35, that is A0 to A3. It is a bidirectional address lines. It is used to select internal registers during programming mode. Okay, then pin number 37, 38, 39 and 40, that is A4 to A7. These lines is a unidirectional address lines, that is A4 to A7 act as unidirectional address lines activated only during DMA operation. Then pin number 36, EOP, that is end of process. It is active as low signal, that is bidirectional pin. It is used to indicate the completion of DMA operation. The reception of EOP, either internal or external, will cause A237 to terminate the service. That is the function of EOP, end of process. These are the pin details of 8237 DMA, direct memory access. So, this is the functional block diagram of 8237. So, 8237 contains three basic blocks of control logic. The first one is timing control block. Second one, program command control block. Third one, priority encoder block. Let's see the first block. That is timing and control block. This block generates internal timing from the clock input and external control signals for the 8237 DMA controller. Okay. So, program command control block. So, this command control block decodes the various command given to the 8237 by the microprocessor prior to servicing a DMA request. It also decodes the mode control word used to select the type of DMA during the servicing. So, this is about program command control block. The third block called priority encoder block. This block resolves priority connection between DMA channels requesting services simultaneously. Actually, the 8237 contains 24 internal registers. They are base address register, base word count register, current address register, current word count register, temporary address register, temporary word count register, status register, command register, temporary register, mode register, mask register, request register. The size of base register, current register, temporary register are 16 bits. The remaining register size 8 bit. Okay. So, let's see one by one. The first one is base address and base word count register. So, this is 16 bit register. This register are used to store the original starting address and original number of bytes to be transferred. That is the use of base register and base word count register. During the DMA operation, the content of the base address and base word count register is loaded in CW register. Okay, control word register. So, these register cannot be read by the microprocessor. Second one, current address register, that is a CAR. It is a 16-bit register. It is used to hold current memory address being accessed during the DMA transfer. The address is automatically incremented or decremented after each transfer and the resulting address value is stored in the current register. Then third register, that is current word register, that is CW. So, it is a 16-bit register. This register determines the number of data transfer to be performed. After each data transfer, the word count is decremented. The intermediate value of the word count is stored in the current word register, where the count value becomes zero and EOP, end of process, signal will be generated. After the EOP, this register may be reinitialized using auto initialize command signal. Then next one, command register. So it is an 8-bit register which controls the operation of 8237. It is programmed by the microprocessor and it is cleared by the reset operation or master clear instruction. The command register is used to program the following features of 8237. The first one is enable or disable memory to memory transfer. Second feature, enable or disable DMA controller. Third one, normal or compressed timing. Then fourth one, fixed or rotating priority. Then types of DMA request, that is whether it is active high or low, and acknowledgement signal. Then the format of control word to be loaded in command register, that is shown in the next diagram. The bits B0 and B1 are used to select the any one channel, okay, that is first two bits. Okay, B0 and B1 are used to select any one channel among four channels. Then bit B2 is used to turn on or turn off the entire controller by software. Then B3 is used to program the normal or compressed timing. Then bit number 4, 0 means a fixed priority, 1 indicates a rotating priority. Then bit number 5, 0 indicates late write selection, if 1 indicates extended write selection. Then 6 indicates DREQ sends active high, 1 indicates the bit value is 1 means DREQ sends active low. Then last bit, that is at B7, if the bit value is equal to 0, acknowledgement signal sends the active low signal. Suppose the bit value 1 means acknowledgement signal, that is a DMA acknowledgement, sends the active high signal. So this is about command register. Then mode register. Here every channel has its own mode register. It is used to program the following features of 8237. Here the possibility are read, write, verify, transfer content, then demand or single or block of data transfer, then single DMA operation or cascaded operation of 8237, then enable or disable auto initialization. Then the control word format of mode register is shown here. That is, the first two bits indicates channel selection. If 00 means channel 0 is selected, 01 channel 1 is selected, then 10 condition channel 2 is selected, then 11 condition channel 3 is selected. Then D2 and D3 indicates verify operation or write operation or read operation. Okay, that is a 00 means that is verify transfer content, 01 condition write transfer content, 10 condition read transfer content, 11 illegal. Suppose XX means if bits are 6 and 7, that is 11 bits. Then bit number 4, that is if the bit value 0 means auto initialization disable. If the bit value is equal to 1, auto initialization enable. Okay, then bit number 5, if the bit value is equal to 0, the address is incremented, then 1 indicates the address is decremented. Okay, then bit number 6 and 7, that is 00 means demand mode select, 01 condition single mode select, 10 condition block mode select, 11 condition cascade mode select. So this is the request register format. So request register is a non-maskable register. It is used to request DMA transfer via software. Each bit is set or reset under program control. The first two bits, the bit value may be 00, that indicates channel 0 is selected, 01 channel 1 is selected, 10 condition channel 2 is selected, 11 channel 3 is selected. Then bit number 2, if the bit value is equal to 0 means reset DMA request. If the bit value is equal to 1, set DMA request. Okay, the remaining bits, that is D3 to D7, don't care. Okay, so these bits are not used in 8237. So this is mask register format. Mask register is used to mask the DMA channels. The mask register has two internal address. One address is used to set or reset single mask bit, and another address is used to set or reset all the mask bits. So D0, the bit value is equal to 0 means clear channel 0 mask bit. If the bit value is equal to 1, set channel 0 mask bit. Then D1, the bit value is equal to 0 means clear channel 1 mask bit. Then 1 indicates set channel 1 mask bit. Then D2, the D2 value is equal to 0 means clear channel 2 mask bit. If the bit value is equal to 1, set channel 2 mask bit. Then D3, D3 value is equal to 0, clear channel 3 mask bit. If the bit value is equal to 1, set channel 3 mask bit. The remaining bits, that is D4 to D7, don't care. Then status register. The status register keeps the tracks of all the DMA channel pending request and status of the terminal count, that is TC. TC is nothing but terminal count. So this is the status word register format. So D0 indicates if the bit value is equal to 1 means channel 0 has reached terminal count. Then D1 is equal to 1 indicates channel 1 has reached terminal count. Then D2 bit value is equal to 1, channel 2 has reached terminal count. Then D3 is equal to 1, channel 3 has reached terminal count. Then D4, if D4 is equal to 1, channel 0 DMA request is active. If D5 is equal to 1, channel 1 DMA request is active. If D6 is equal to 1, channel 2 DMA request is active. If D7 is equal to 1, channel 3 DMA request is active. Then temporary register. The temporary register holds the data during memory to memory data transfer. After the completion of the transfer of operation, the last word transferred remains in the temporary register till it is cleared by the reset operation. These are the register details of DMA controller. Then DMA operation with A237, that is, the A237 can be operated in two cycles. The first one is idle cycle, second one active cycle. The A237 initially is in idle state. So in this state, A237 does not have any valid pending DMA request. Once there is a DMA request, the A237 enters S0 state, which is the first state of the DMA operation. When the A237 requests the CPU for the DMA operation, then the CPU has not acknowledged the request, the A237 wait in S0 state. Once we get acknowledgement signal from the CPU, then the data transfer can begin. Okay, so S1, S2, S3 and S4 are the working states of DMA operation in which the actual data transfer is carried out. If more time is required to complete a transfer than allowed time means wait state may be inserted between S2 and S3 or S3 and S4 using ready pin of A237. To perform memory read or memory write of DMA operation, we need 4 states, S0, S1, S2 and S3. Otherwise, S1, S2, S3 and S4. Then the first mode, that is a transfer mode of A237. In this mode, the A237 is in the idle cycle if there is no pending request, or the A237 is waiting for a request from one of the DMA channels. Once a channel requests a DMA service, the A237 sends the hold request to the CPU using its HRQ pin. If the CPU acknowledges the hold request on HLDA, the 8237 enters an active cycle. In the active cycle, the actual data transfer takes place in any one of the following methods, that is, single transfer mode or block transfer mode or demand transfer mode or cascaded mode. Let's see one by one, single transfer mode. So in this mode, the device transfers only one byte per request. So the word count is decremented and the address is decremented or incremented after each byte transfer. When the count becomes zero, the terminal count state is reached. That is the meaning. For each transfer, the DREQ must be active until the DAC is activated. Okay, DMA acknowledgement signal is activated in order to get recognized. After TC, okay, that is after terminal count, the bus will be relinquished for the CPU. For a new DREQ line of 8237, it will again activate the HRQ signal to the CPU and the HLDA signal from the CPU will push the 8237 again into single transfer mode. This mode is also called cycle stealing. Okay, then the second mode, that is a block transfer mode. In this mode, the 8237 is activated by DREQ to continue the transfer until a terminal count is reached. That is, a block of data is transferred. Auto initialization may be programmed in this mode. This transfer cycle may be terminated due to EOP, end of processor, which forces terminal count. The DREQ needs to be activated only till the DAC signal is activated by the DMA controller. Then third type, that is a demand transfer mode. In this mode, the device continues transfer until a terminal count is reached or an external EOP is detected or DREQ signal goes inactive. After the IO device is able to catch up, the service may be re-established, activating the DREQ signal again. Then fourth mode, that is cascaded mode. In this mode, more than one 8237 can be connected together to provide more than four DMA channels. The HRQ and HLDA signal from additional 8237 are connected with DREQ and DAC pins of a channel of the host 8237 respectively. The priority of the DMA request may be preserved at each level. The first device is only used for priority additional device and it does not generate any address or control signal of its own. So, the host of 8237 will respond to DREQ generated by slaves and generates the DAC and the HRQ signals to coordinate all the slaves. All other outputs of the host 8237 are disabled condition. Then memory to memory transfer. In this mode, that is memory to memory transfer, is used to transfer a block of data from one set of memory address to another one. So here 8237 multiplexes the 8 high order address bits, that is A8 to A15 on the data lines. The state, that is S1, that is ideal mode, is used to transfer the high order address bits to a latch from which they are to be placed on the address bus. Then the falling edge of the address strobe signal is used to load these higher address bits from data lines to the latch. The lower order address A0 to A7 is directly generated by 8237 on its A0 to A7 pins.